Hello everyone and welcome to our channel. I'm TJ and today's video tutorial will be about this beautiful crochet baby blanket here. It's super easy pattern. It's 10 stitches repeat and 4 row repeat. You can see here I used three different colors, and the stitch pattern is double crochet stitch, front post treble crochet, and for the border again we will use single crochet and double crochet stitch, which I will show in detail how to make in this tutorial. For this baby blanket, for the body part I use 7mm crochet hook and 6mm for the border. The yarn I used is Lion brand woolen is, which is 8% acrylic and 20% wool. It's 4 weight medium yarn. It's 85 grams per bow and 180 meters. For this blanket I used 2 bows per color, but from each second bow this is the leftover. I didn't use the second bow at all. What else I can tell you? The measurements for the blanket, the measurements for this blanket are 30 inches to 30 inches with the border. First we will work in rows, then we will work in rounds for our border part. The written instructions for this blanket you can find in our blog. I will leave the link in the comment section and in the description box below, and in this right corner here you can click to link to get the written instructions. I hope you enjoy this tutorial with me, and if you have any questions feel free to comment below and I will do my best to answer in ASAP. So if you are ready, let's start to crochet this beautiful blanket together. To start our blanket pattern, we have to chain 81. I prepared my chains. I have 81 chains because the pattern is multiple of 10 plus 11. Now I will show how to make row 1. For row 1, we will start with double crochet on 4 chain from hook, which is 1, 2, 3 and 4. For double crochet stitch we have to make yarn over, insert your hook into this fourth chain, yarn over and pull through. We have 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through these 2 loops, 2 loops on the hook, yarn over and pull through. Then we will continue with double crochet across till the end of this row. Let me show you one more time how to make this super easy double crochet stitch. Yarn over, insert your hook into the next stitch, yarn over and pull through. We have 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through these 2 loops, yarn over and pull through. This is the double crochet stitch. Continue crocheting double crochet stitch till the end of this row and let's meet at row 2. I finished my first row and now for row 2, turn your work, chain 3, then make 1 double crochet in next stitch. Chain 3 is count as a stitch here and throughout the pattern. Now yarn over, insert your hook, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through and yarn over, pull through. Repeat this till the end of this row. Let's meet at the end of row 2 so I can show how to change the color, because we will take our second color for row 3. At the end of row 2, don't forget to make a double crochet onto the top of our turning chain 3 here. Yarn over and pull through. Yarn over and pull through one more time. When we have 2 loops on the hook, we will cut the yarn. cut the yarn, and we will take our second color. Here I will use the gray color yarn because with the white one it's not visible well for the video tutorial, so you have to take your white color or the color you choose for your second one and pull through these two loops. Now we switched our color to color B. Turn your work. And now again chain 3. Then we have to make double crochet in second stitch here. And now we will start making our front post treble crochet stitch. I will show how to make. We have to make it 2 rows below, which means we have to make it in this stitch here in our first row. So let's make it. Yarn over once, yarn over twice, then insert your hook into this third stitch of our first double crochet row here, yarn over and pull through, pull a bit more for enough height, yarn over, pull through these two loops, 3 loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through these two loops again, 2 loops on the hook, and yarn over, pull through. This is our front post treble crochet. Then skip the stitch behind and make 1 double crochet in next stitch. You have to repeat this one more time. Again, yarn over once, yarn over twice, insert your hook in next stitch of our first double crochet row here, yarn over, pull through, pull a bit more for enough height. We have 4 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through these 2 loops. We have 3 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through, 2 loops on the hook, and yarn over, pull through. This is the second front post treble crochet. Again, skip the stitch here behind this front post treble crochet and make 1 double crochet in next stitch. And again, front post treble crochet in next stitch. Yarn over twice, insert your hook, pull through, yarn over, and pull through. Now we have to make double crochet in next 5 stitches. Don't forget to skip the stitch behind the front post treble crochet. Let's make them. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Again, front post treble crochet in next stitch. Double crochet in next one, front post treble in next, double crochet in next one, and front post treble crochet in next stitch. You have to repeat this till the end of our row 3. You have to repeat these 10 stitches here. Double crochet in next 5 stitches and front post, double, front post, double, and front post. This is the 10 stitches you have to repeat till the end of this row. Let me show one more time. Double crochet in next 5 stitches. Sorry, you have to repeat this till the last 2 stitches of our row 3. I made 5 double crochet. Now I will make front post treble crochet in next stitch. then double crochet in next one, front post treble in next one, double crochet in next, and again front post treble crochet in next stitch. Repeat this till the last two stitches and let's meet there. So I finish row 3 till the last two stitches, and now in these two last stitches we will make double crochet in each stitch. 1, 2. Then we will turn our work, chain 3, and again we will make double crochet in each stitch across till the end of this row. In each wrong side row we will make double crochet in each stitch. This is our right side of our blanket and this is the wrong side. In each of our wrong side rows we will make double crochet in each stitch across till the end of the rows. This is our fourth row and continue with double crochet in each stitch across till the end of this row. Do not finish the last double crochet stitch and switch to your third color yarn. I will switch again to the red color yarn because it's more visible than the white one. So let's finish this fourth row and see you in row 5. I finished my fourth row and now for row 5 I switch to my third color. It must be the third one, but as I told you with white it's not visible well, so I again switch to the first color. So it will be better, you can see with two colors how it will look, the pattern, how it will be. Again for row 5, chain 3. Then we have to make double crochet in next 6 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then again we have to repeat the front post double crochet section of our row 3. Let me show you one more time. Again we will make front post treble crochet 2 rows below, which means you have to make it in this stitch here. Let's make it together. Yarn over twice, insert your hook here, yarn over and pull through, pull for enough height, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, and yarn over, pull through. Then again don't forget to skip the stitch behind this front post treble crochet and make 1 double crochet in next stitch. Then again front post treble crochet in next stitch, double crochet in next one, and front post treble in next stitch. Then you have to make double crochet in next 5 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then the front post treble crochet section again. Yarn over, double crochet in next one, yarn over, double crochet in next one, and front post treble crochet in next. Again, you have to repeat these 10 stitches here, which are double crochet in next 5 stitches and front post treble crochet section, which is front post treble crochet, double crochet, repeat 2 times and make last front post treble crochet. Repeat these 10 stitches till the last 7 stitches of our row 5. So continue crocheting and let's meet there. At the end of row 5, in the last 7 stitches, we need to make double crochet in each stitch. Let's make them together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Then turn your work and for each wrong side row, as I told you, we have to make double crochet in each stitch. Chain 3 and make double crochet in each stitch. After each wrong side row, you have to switch to your next color if you want to make the blanket colorful as mine. So to get this pattern done, you have to repeat row 3, 4, 5 and 6. We have 4 rows repeat. The first 2 rows are as setup row, so you have to repeat row 3, 4, 5 and 6. Continue crocheting and I will show now how to make the border. After a few more repeats of our 4 row repeat pattern, you will get this beautiful blanket as mine here. As you can see, in total I have 62 rows and I have 79 stitches. Now I will show how to make the border. You can see I used 3 different colors, but you can use 2 different colors as well, as in the part here. I think both are beautiful as well. So if you are ready, let's show you how to make the border. For the border I will use 6 millimeter crochet hook. So for the border with 6 millimeter crochet hook, insert your hook in this third chain from our turning chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Insert it here, take the yarn, pull through, then chain 1, and now we will make our first corner space. In this same chain here, you have to make 1 single crochet, chain 1 and 1 single crochet again. Then we will continue to work in these chain spaces here and we will make in the first chain space, we will make 2 single crochets. Then in the next one, 1 single crochet, 2 single crochets in same chain space and 1 single crochet in next one, 2 single crochets and 1 single crochet in next one. Repeat this till the end of this side of our blanket and let's meet in our next corner space. I finished this side of my blanket and I'm in my second corner, which is here. Again, in this corner we have to make our corner space, which is single crochet, chain one and single crochet all in same space. Then we will make one single crochet in each stitch here. One single crochet in each stitch. And again, when we come to our corner, our last stitch, which will be, let me show you, which will be again here, we have to make in the chain 3 space, on top of this chain 3 here, we have to make single crochet, chain 1, single crochet, and then again we have to continue as the first side here. We will start with two single crochets in first chain space, again one single crochet, two single crochet in the next chain space, one single crochet till the other corner, where again we will make single crochet, chain one, single crochet all in next stitch here, and then we will make again single crochet in each stitch in this side again. So continue crocheting and see you after this first round of our border. For second round of our border, we will start by chaining 2, then we will make one double crochet on top of our single crochet here. Then in chain 1 space of our corner we will make again single crochet, chain 1, single crochet. Then we will make one double crochet in next single crochet stitch here and one single crochet in next stitch, one double crochet in next stitch, one single crochet in next one, one double crochet, one single crochet. Continue crocheting till the other corner and let's meet there. Now I am one stitch before my second corner space. In this last stitch here I will make again double crochet, and then we will make single crochet, chain 1, single crochet in our corner space, and again double crochet in next stitch, single crochet in next one, double crochet in next stitch, single crochet in next one. Repeat this for the other two sides. And in each corner you have to make chain 1, single crochet, chain 1, single crochet, all in the corner space here. So continue crocheting the other two sides and let's meet for our third row of our for round 3 of our border. At the last corner of our round 2, we will finish with single crochet in this last stitch here. Then we will join on top of our first double crochet stitch. Then we will chain 1 and we will make one single crochet in our first stitch, then one double crochet in next one, and single crochet, chain 1, single crochet in our corner chain 1 space, then again one double crochet, one single crochet in next stitch. You have to repeat this to the other corner. The difference here is that in the round 2 of our border we made single crochet, double crochet in next stitch, single crochet, double crochet in next stitch, alternating these 2 stitches. Now for this second round we will alternate again the same stitches, but this time we will make double crochet on top of our single crochet and single crochet on top of our double crochet stitch, alternating this. This is the difference between the two, the round 2 and round 3 of our border. So continue crocheting, alternating these 2 stitches, and let's meet in our second corner, and I will show how to continue for the other side. For our second corner again we will make the same steps. I made one double crochet on top of the single crochet stitch here, then I will make single crochet, chain 1, single crochet in next chain 1 space here to make the corner, and double crochet in next stitch, single crochet in next one, and again we will continue alternating these 2 stitches. You have to repeat the same steps for the other 2 sides as well, and you have to repeat round 2 and round 3 2 more times. So let's crochet this till the end, and let's crochet 2 more rounds of round 2 and round 3, and I will show the final result of our border. So continue crocheting and see you there. As you can see, I finished my border. As I told you, I made 2 more rounds for border, and here it is. Let me show you closer. This is the finished border of my blanket. I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. If so, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and to ring the bell button so you can be notified when we upload a new video tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below and I will do my best to answer in ASAP. I will leave the written instructions in the comment section and in the description box down below, so you can check them later to see for the written instructions of this blanket. See you soon!